We're herding cattle and loading them trains. That's right, it's Great Western Trail from Plan B Games. My nose made a weird sound in that one. GWT pits 2 to 4 players in a cattle count competition to be the most profitable wrestler around these here parts. Setup for GWT is a bit complicated, but a detailed guide can be found in the intricate rule book. If you follow the steps, it's super easy, people. So I'm going to summarize the game components and the sections of the board before we jump into gameplay. Players are taking on the role of cattle women, or cattle dudes if you have men playing, as they journey to Kansas City to profit from their herd, made up of various cattle cards. The players' decks begin with starting cattle cards, worth no victory points, and during the game they take from the market cattle cards, which have higher breeding values, here, and victory point values, here. Like many deck builder games, players draw a hand from their private deck and may use those cards on their turn. And if they run out of cards to draw, their private discard is shuffled and creates a new draw deck. You know, a deck builder. The game board features a winding series of paths leading from the Texan plains to Kansas City. Along their journey, players will interact with location tiles and gain various rewards or pay fees in the form of dollars. Some actions require players to discard cards from their hand, which always go into their personal discard pile. As players gain other cards, these also go in their discard to be added into the mix once a player's draw deck is depleted. See what I did with the pronoun? The game board starts with 7 neutral buildings in the first game, organized by letter. Afterwards, it can be random. These are also the potential starting spaces for players in their first turn. There are 3 hazard sections and 1 Indian trade section, creating tolls for the players, but also victory points or dollars when they're removed from the board. The job market on the left side of the board features the worker tiles of the game, available for hire to the players. As players gain workers, they will add them to their player board, providing more options for victory. Cowboys increase your buying power at the cattle market. Craftsmen allow you to build more powerful buildings, and engineers provide bonus train movement. Toot toot, bitches. Kansas City, the constant destination for cattlemen in the game, is in the top left, and has special spaces for players to cash in their herd and ship them out on the rails. Starting tiles for workers, hazards, and teepees are sorted into piles based on their backside numbers and randomly distributed to the board and job market depending on the number of players. Along the top and right edges of the board lies the railroad track, station master spaces, and cities. As players ship their cattle, they can send them to various cities for victory points in the end game. Players will also move their engines and can pay to upgrade the stations along the way, providing even more bonuses. Let's see what the players get. Each of them ranchers are gonna pick a color and take a player board, 14 player discs, 1 certificate marker, and a cattleman figure. The discs cover various actions on the left side and bonuses on the top and right to be revealed as the game progresses. If a player removes the disc, they gain the benefit underneath. After taking the 14 starting cattle cards of their color, the player shuffles and creates a personal draw deck to the left of their board, from which they will draw 4 cards. There's also 1 train engine per player on the starting space of the train track. The train's progression provides discount costs to transport cattle to various American cities. Players also each have a set of 10 private buildings, double-sided, of their own color. During setup, the particular side for each building is determined once randomly by flipping a tile in the air, and then all players must set their private buildings to that side. In this way, everybody has access to the same buildings, but those options vary game to game. Each player also receives a randomly dealt starting objective card to be placed below their board. Determine the starting player. They get $6 from the bank, and each subsequent player gets $7, $8, or $9, depending on how many players. Players select a starting neutral building to place their cattlemen and can now start this game. Whew. Gameplay occurs in turns, each divided into 3 phases, after which it's the next player's turn. The phases are move, use, draw. Pretty simple, right? During the move phase, players can move their cattleman figure along the path in the direction of the arrows. If they reach a fork in the road, they can take whichever path they wish. Movement, determined by the player board and augmented by removing discs, only counts on location tiles. Empty spaces are not counted as locations and are thus skipped on over. A player can move up to their move value and then stop at a location. If a cattleman passes or moves to a tile with a black or green hand, they must also pay a fee to the bank if it's neutral, or to another player if it belongs to them. How much depends on the number of players in the game. Once stopped, they are there for the turn. During the use phase, players can take actions depending on the location where they stopped. If on either the neutral or private building of their color, they can activate that location. If they land on someone else's private building or a hazard or a teepee tile, they may activate their auxiliary actions located on the left of their player board. More options for auxiliary actions can be revealed throughout the game. Possible actions include gaining money, placing private buildings, discarding cards for rewards, removing hazards from the board, moving their train engine, trading with Indians, and so much more. If a player reaches Kansas City, they immediately proceed through the 5 sub-phases to complete their run before returning to the start of the trail. The sub-phases include the foresight spaces, which add new workers to the job market, and hazards and teepee tiles to the board. In the force space is where the players reveal all the cards in their hand and sum up the breeding value of each different type of cattle card. They can optionally augment their breeding total by adding certificates earned along the trail. Then they gain that total in dollars from the bank, set it aside, and discard their hand. In subphase 5, the money they earn this round represents the city a player may transport their cattle to by placing one of the discs from their board onto a city space. Finally, in the draw phase, players draw back up from their deck to their hand limit, which starts at 4, but players can increase to 6 during the game by removing a disc from the hand section of their board. As turns progress, players accumulate victory points for the end game, which is triggered when the job market token has no more rows to slide down. The player who triggered that move keeps that token for 2 victory points and can finish their Kansas City turn, after which each other player gets one final turn to gain some points before they're counted. For the final scoring, use the handy-dandy scoring notepad to determine a victor. Players get points for a ton of assets, including every $5, the sum of private buildings on the board, city crests from delivering to various places, station master tiles, hazard tiles they removed from the board, cattle cards with victory points, workers on the far columns of the player board, any revealed disc spaces, the job market token, and objectives. If any player has any uncompleted objectives they've played in front of them, they lose any points in the negative section of the card. Objectives still in a player's deck can be completed at this time as well. Add up them points and the highest score wins. And that's most of Great Western Trail. There's plenty of details to each individual section of the game, but the rulebook contains handy guides to each, so keep it nearby. I'm Becca Scott, and I could really go for some steak right now. I don't know about you. Also, watch me and my friends play this game and other awesome games on Game the Game right here on Geek and Sundry. I'll see you there.